This DNews episode is brought to you by domain.com.
Everyone loves midnight snacks, but you need to stop because it is making you fat. Hi guys, Catie here for DNews. Are you concerned about your waistline? Of course you are. Everyone is. There is no escape. Well, a new study done by researchers at the Salk Institute shows that consuming your food within a limited time frame could not only help reverse the effects of obesity, but the effects of diabetes as well, at least in mice. Satchidananda Panda, the professor who led the study and also has a phenomenal name that I'm sure I just butchered, conducted a similar study in 2012 wherein he fed 100 mice identical high-fat, high-calorie diets. One group was allowed to consume the food whenever they wanted, while the other group could eat as much as they wanted, but only within an 8-hour time frame. One of the groups fattened up, and I'll bet you can guess which one. But in this new study, things got a little more complicated. The study was done on nearly 400 mice of different sizes, ranging from normal to obese. He fed the mice different kinds of diets consisting of high fat, fat and sucrose, or just fructose. And the final difference was there were varying time restrictions instead of just the 1 8-hour window. To a certain degree, any of the varying diets and time restrictions showed benefits. No matter the diet, the mice who had time restrictions of 9 to 12 hours showed similarly lean mice. The group that was given a 15-hour window, however, saw less results. There was also a group of mice that were given cheat days and were allowed free-range eating only on the weekends. These mice looked very similar to the mice who had time restrictions 7 days a week, which suggests that the diet can even withstand temporary interruptions. But most significantly, the mice who became obese due to the free-range diet were eventually restricted to 9-hour windows. Although they were consuming the same caloric amount, within a few days their body weight dropped by 5%, and eating this way prevented the mice from further weight gain. And while all of this is really interesting, it isn't exactly new information. Intermittent fasting has been a method of weight loss in humans for several years. Humans naturally fast, at least for some amount of time every night when we go to sleep. When we wake up, our fast is broken at breakfast. I know, words mean things sometimes. A super long time ago, humans didn't know how to control fire. So they hunted and ate in the day and protected themselves against predators and slept at night. Then we learned how to control fire and then created artificial light, creating an artificial day and artificial feeding times. Our bodies have circadian rhythms that tell us to stop eating after a certain point in the day, which unfortunately many of us ignore. The later you stay up to, say, watch TV with a bowl of ice cream or drive to Taco Bell for that fourth, fifth, and sixth meal, the more your digestive system, along with all of the hormones and enzymes that manage it, are thrown off and unable to process the food that you eat. And those extra calories end up in all the places that you don't want them in the form of fat. So restricting your intake of food to a certain time frame is basically just extending the time between your last meal and the breaking of your fast, which gives your body the time to burn away your fat stores for energy. Panda's research suggests that the longer we eat, the lazier our metabolisms become. But once you restrict your consumption to an 8 to 12 hour window, our metabolisms will burn more calories day and night. What do you guys think of this? Are you going to try to stop eating after a certain hour? Let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe for all the DNews goodness, and you can follow me on Twitter @KatieWayne if you want to know what I'm up to. I'll see you next time.